like, I mean, I've sort of been around property now for about 6 years, and there's certain elements of property that I'm really good at. Like, I just love going out and chatting to people and doing deals and, you know, just finding creative solutions to problems. Like, love it. But there's so much about property I don't love. Like, I don't really enjoy working with builders or project managing. I've got no real interest in learning about that. I don't really enjoy paperwork. All I really want to be doing is just going out and finding deals. So we've got a group of six people, and what we're doing is basically pooling our skills and resources.
You've got to consider yourselves as problem solvers. That's all you're doing. You're just solving problems. You're selling the seller's problems, the tenant's problems, literally you're just solving everyone's problems. The better problem solver you are, the more money you'll make in property, period.
That's why I love property negotiating, because there's so many problems you can solve.
Yeah.
And so I think, like, having a team of people and knowing that we've got people that are good at every aspect of property just means that the growth of the company and the ability to deliver on what we say is just going to be, like, way better than what I could do on my own.
Can I buy a laminator? Please, let me buy a laminator.
I've got a laminator.
Can I buy a laminator, like, long-term length?
What's good about laminators?
Love laminating.
She just loves stationery and
just
weird.
She just
weird.
Shreds stuff.
She, like,
does.
I'm not judging. No judgment.
Neither am I. I love the fact that she's weird about laminating.
I hyperventilated in Paper Chase on Tottenham
Court Road. Chief laminator.
I think a lot of people think that landlords are just greedy people and stuff like that. And I just think, yeah, a lot of those things aren't true. You know, like, I mean, like, I'm wanting to offer good accommodation to people. I mean, don't get me wrong, like, there are some landlords out there that will rent a HMO with more people than they should, or won't you know, do the necessary work to bring a property up to its standard. But what I feel like we're about in this group is offering, you know, good standard accommodation, where we can make some money, tenants get good accommodation, investors get good returns on the money, and everyone wins.
They're really thankful of me. Like,
yeah.
I speak to them.
Yeah, like, yeah. Everyone needs to be happy. It's a win-win. It's not like you guys win, the other person's, you know, kind of being done over.
Rent to rent, in a nutshell, is where you've got sort of like a landlord that's probably like, doesn't really want to manage their property anymore, or can't get the tenants, or just fed up, or something along those lines. And like, someone like, I'll go along and I'll have a chat to them, find out what their circumstances is, and what I'll do is I'll take a property that's essentially could be a HMO or has got a HMO license. So a HMO, just for anyone that doesn't know, is a house of multiple occupancy, so it's where you rent the rooms out, like, individually. Yeah, so I'll get someone that's got a property like that, and then I'll have a look at it, and I'll basically give them a family rent price for that property, and then what I'll do then is rent out the rooms individually.
You've got to make sure you've got enough fridge and freezer space for the number of tenants. I don't know how you do it. Like, in mine, I've got two fridge freezers, so everyone's got a shelf and a drawer.
From HMO license in Cardiff, it's a shelf
and a drawer each. Yeah, and I think that's just nice anyway for people.
Tell you what I do. What I've done in mine is,
so the fridge freezer has to be appropriate size wise.
It does cost more money. I've got a little fridge freezer in every room. Do you know the little part ones that come to that?
Yeah.
I've got one in every room.
Interesting.
There's in mine, there's only enough space for one small fridge.
Right.
And, like, there's five people.
Yeah.
But also, like, people love the fact there's a fridge in their room.
Yeah.
And it means there's no fighting over food.
No one loses their milk. No one worries about anything. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's all in their room.
So they all like that, do they?
Yeah.
Cool.
So, just a typical example. A property that I've done recently, it's got five bedrooms, and the gross rent that comes in off that is £1,965. And after all expenses have gone out and what I pay to the landlord, which is £800 a month, it makes me just over £700 a month. So that's like an overview, really, of what rent to rent is. And what I've done is I've agreed a 5-year contract with that landlord. So basically what they're getting is a guaranteed rent for 5 years. No hassle, no maintenance, nothing to do. So it's a win for them. And what we get is we get to have a property essentially for a low investment. The amount of money I put into that was just over £5,000. And the return is well over 100% on the money invested with the profit. So that's like a basic overview of rent to rent.
I reckon to do the 12 rent to rents, we probably need a max of £84,000.
Yeah, but then you'll have rent coming in as well, topping it up.
Yeah, I think we can't do it physically.
Get topping out.
Daisy, come here.
Yeah, because there's going to be people out there that have got money just sitting around doing nothing. Within the people I know and the other people in the group know, that would prefer to get a higher return than what the banks offer.
The people you want are, their money is in the bank at 0.3% and you're going to give them 5. That's what I want you to think about when you're looking for people.
The bank offers nothing. Like, in fact, if you leave money in the bank, you're probably losing money on that money, really, when you consider all things.
It's insane. Anyone who's got any money just sat in the bank, not earning any money, like, they are nuts not to do this. Just absolutely nuts. Like, why would you not? And all right, there has to be an element of trust, and there has to be an element of security, and they have to know that, you know, they can trust that you've got their best interests at heart, and that, you know, and I've said to the other groups, and I'll say it to you guys, by hook or by crook, you pay that bloody investor's money back, whatever happens. I don't care if you guys really screw up on the deal, the investor doesn't pay for that, you guys do. Do you know what I mean? It's like, you've got to give them their money and their interest rate back, just like you would a bank. And you'll also get people go, oh, 5%, is that all? I could get more somewhere else. You say, best of luck, off you go. Yeah, like literally, because it's like, go for it.
With investing money, I think with everyone, it's a matter of trust. And I think the first thing to do if you're sort of thinking, do I want to invest or do I not want to invest, is make an approach, have a meeting, get to know the person that you might want to invest with, and then if everyone's happy, gets on, and you've all got the same sort of vision, I think just go for it. And maybe even, like, you know, if you're really unsure, try a smaller amount, something that you know that's not too scary. So you could, like, let's say you've got £100,000, but you think, well, I didn't want to invest all that because what if I lose it? Why not just invest 10, 15, 20 and see how that goes?
Say, look, this is what we're doing, this is how we're doing it. We're starting to look for deals now. So within the next 2 or 3 months, we'll be looking for money. So if in principle you're okay with it, can I show you the agreements now? Can we swap them so that at the point when we say, yes, we're ready to go, all we've got to do is sign and transfer the money. And that's what you need, everyone at that point.
Worst case scenario, if it all went wrong, you'd probably get your money back. Best case scenario is we form a long-term relationship and you're making, you know, way better money on the money that's already there, really.
Lie down.
She doesn't listen
to
me either.
Are you serious?
Lie down.
I love the way she's like, all right, I'll sit.
She had to throw it for me, she said.
I had to pull her out from under the desk the other day, and you were like, just pull her neck. And I was like, I can't. And she was literally like, sliding
along with me. My initial goal before I joined the group was to basically, by the time I retired, just to have 10 houses, HMOs all paid off. And then that money would be my retirement fund, basically. I think within the power of this group, I think we can do more than that.
Out of all the leads I get, 50% are probably going to want to sell and 50% are probably going to want to rent. So that means, like, in the course of a year...
It could be a lease option or it could be a direct buy.
Yeah. It's not going to be like 90% want to do rent to rent and 10% want to sell. In fact, sometimes it's higher that they want to sell.
Yeah.
Then they want to rent because they're not used to that.
But then you can negotiate the sale with rent up until the point you buy. Effectively, aren't you? You're saying to them, fine, we'll buy off you when we've sorted out.
I think in the long term, I'd like a portfolio of properties that's basically passive, that pays, you know, maybe £10,000 a month passive income, but I'd like that to be able to continue to grow. So it's sort of like, that's sort of a goal for now, but I think within that, I'd like it to be growing every year anyway. I think once you've got to that point of expansion, the money that's coming in, you can have a pot that just goes into growth and it just continually self-funds growth.
So, £9,000 a month?
Yeah.
Yeah.
12 months. Oh yes, it started to go to pot where one of you went 12 months and I was just like, my brain just went...
£1,500 each per month.
That's too short.
12 rent to rent,
I don't know, because I can't hold you back. I've got to be careful, I don't hold you back.
Well, even if we let's aim for that.
Yeah.
And if we miss it by a little bit, we get 10.
Yeah.
We were talking about this today, and I think with a lot of people, you can learn a strategy But then why doesn't everyone just implement the strategies they've learned? Because there must be millions of people out there that know strategies on things but don't do anything.
Yeah, so there's nothing wrong with the content. The courses are good, the content's good, but they don't deal with who's on the course and what they need to succeed. They're just selling a strategy. It's the action, dealing with who you are, dealing with what you want, dealing with what stops you. That's the bit. Yeah, that's the bit that stops everyone, and that's what's not dealt with. If you buy a strategy course, this strategy works if you've sorted out what you need. It's not his job to do that. He's quite clearly selling a property course that's strategy.
I just love talking about property. I love talking about these types of things. So even if it doesn't go anywhere, like, I'd just say, let's have a chat and just see what happens. You know, whatever, what the worst case scenario is, I'll buy you a coffee maybe, I don't know. Or maybe even a scone or a brownie or something. I don't know. Yeah, we'll figure it out. But yeah, get in touch about it then.
It's to purchase.
It's getting mighty close to the old nuts, isn't it?